us this morning right here on Studio 10. We're marking a very special anniversary and a very special sound in music. Let's take a look back now.
Fifty years ago, the Beach Boys hit number one in the charts with this classic hit. Their space-age sound came from this piece of electronic wizardry, the Theremin. And it's all thanks to this man. Yes, in 1920, Russian-born engineer and physicist Leon Theremin developed the instrument as part of his research into proximity sensors. It quickly found fame with science fiction and horror movie producers in Hollywood. And with the right moves, you can play virtually anything on it. It's a conversation stopper. Just ask the Big Bang Theory's Sheldon Cooper.
What are you doing?
Playing the theremin.
Wow. And here is the theremin, and Elizabeth Jigalin is a University of Sydney music student at the Sydney Conservatorium of Music, and welcome her to Studio 10. Elizabeth, when we hear all that iconic music, now we understand this little magic piece of musical equipment is responsible. Tell us how it works.
So essentially, the way that it works is that there are two antennae. And so what you'll notice, if I can get you to move your hand closer... Ooh.
Sure.
..to the theremin. you can actually hear that the sound is getting higher. So now, if you move away... It's getting lower.
Wow.
And then so...
What happens if I use two?
Yeah, so now this antenna here, the horizontal one...
Oh, this is an antenna, this
Yeah,
bit.
This bit that curves around here.
And then this bit.
Yep, so two antenna, one horizontal, one vertical. As I move my hand away from this antenna, volume gets louder. But as I go closer... quiet.
Wow.
So that affects the way that you play it as well.
Wow. So can you play some music on it?
Yeah, so...
Do you want us to step away or does that affect it?
No, let's just see what happens.
Okay.
So I'll show you a few different sounds. So this theremin that I have here, not only can we hear kind of the classical, more traditional theremin sound, but some other cool things as well.
Okay, let's right. fly.
Just improvising at this stage.
Yes.
So it's kind of a take on some Star Wars, but.
Yeah.
All right. So let's hear some other sounds.
It's very spooky, isn't it? I guess they used it a lot in sci-fi movies.
Yeah. It's pretty much every Scooby-Doo episode you've ever seen.
Have a go.
Okay.
So you need to make sure that you have one hand coming towards this antenna here, and then you can control the sound here. So you're kind of taking the notes almost out of the air.
Wow.
Oh! Does it play when I'm calling
yes.
you? Ooh.
Ooh. Wow.
Yeah. So it's pretty cool. So now we can get some sounds like this as well.
Oh, that's awesome.
Sorry, it must have been something I...
Bananas.
Wow.
Ooh, that's cool.
So is this part of an orchestration of, like, you play it on with an orchestra? Would you do it?
Well, you could, and so often it has been actually used to play classical repertoire. But some of the interests that I have, so I'm a composition student at the Con, and so I'm interested in new music and kind of creating new sounds with it. Yeah.
Right. So you literally...
What happens when you're a kid and you say, Mum, Dad, I want to learn to play the theremin? Are there theremin teachers? Do you
YouTube as well.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so YouTube, yeah, there's, I know that there's people who offer Skype lessons as well. Wow. So it's, yeah, it's definitely a unique instrument, and one of the reasons I wanted to play it is because I couldn't find anyone else to play it. So.
Can I have a go?
Yeah, sure.
I've never even seen it. And this is amazing. Like, in all seriousness, this is the instrument that the Beach Boys introduced on Pet Sounds, which people say is the most influential record in the history of pop music. It's what inspired Sgt. Pepper and basically responsible for everything we know today. Okay, and this is how we do it.
It is awesome, isn't it?
Yeah. And because you're hearing all of the notes in between that, sometimes on a piano or there's a lot of instruments that you can't explore that.
And you're playing the instrument without even touching it. This is so much fun.
I appreciate this may not be as much fun for everyone else.
But we're having lots of fun. Elizabeth, you've been so amazing. Thank you so much for joining us.